You have a family, your mother is there, father is there, they're all poor. You also have kids to take care of. So you end up getting frustrated and, you know, get involved in this criminal activity in the area here.
Mimi naona jamaa mwingine ananiita mimi mwizi. Watu wamekuja wameanza kunifomia.
Mimi si ule mbaya mlikuwa mnanielewa. Mimi nimereform nimekuwa mtu mzuri. Nimereform nimekuwa mtu mzuri ambapo ile walifu yote ilikuwa ninafanya niliamua kuacha kwa sababu ni vitu niliona ambapo haiwezi nisaidia.
All right, those were some of the chilling confessions when it comes to crime. Good evening, Kenya and East Africa. You are on Youth Cafe. Tonight, we will be discussing crime amongst the youth. My name is Nziki Biku.
And the hottest man in East and Central Africa, Brian Asili, tukuna vitu kibao, tume prepare. Of course, kuna art segment, ama inaitwa art corner. Sio art segment, inaitwa art corner. We have Techno It with Nziki Biku. Zizi, siju me prepare nini?
Oh, you guys are just gonna have to wait and see, all right?
To wait and see. Let's wait and see.
Because I have a cold. It's because of the cold.
Ndio maana nasikia sauti yako leo umeamua, hi Kenya. Like, hi Kenya, but it's okay. We have a lot of things prepared for you. Lakini stories alone ni moto kuruka. Bado Donald Trump, akuna story ya kutuambia hapa, imagine.
And the thing is, what Asili is also talking about is that last week on Friday, it had to come a day after we did the show, or a few hours after we did the show.
Imagine.
So last week on Friday, Angela Merkel, that's the German Chancellor, met up with Donald Trump at White House, or rather, yes, at White House. I was about to say State House, but at White House. And this is the thing, they met and they were discussing issues like Afghanistan, Ukraine, as well as America's stand when it comes to NATO. Now, on top of this, what people are talking about is the snub that Donald Trump gave to Angela Merkel, one of the most powerful women in the world.
Imagine, now watu wameanza kusema ati ni sexism, ati that is exactly what men do to women across the world. Yoni ukweli kweli zizi.
Well, this is being Donald Trump.
Sinilo utulenga.
All right, we want you rather to take a look at this video.
Send a good picture back to Germany, please. Make
sure. Thank you. Handshake. Okay. Thank you, fellas.
So, oh my goodness.
Imagine, umeenda all the way to the other side of the world. Alafu unasalimia mtu wanakulenga. Miuki, wanakujua ni kutulenga tu wanatulenga, sindio?
That's the thing. And let me tell you something. Social media had a lot to say about Donald Trump snubbing Angela Merkel. But however, very many people are saying that he was snubbing the journalist and not really Angela Merkel. But to make things, you know, fair, he did greet her when she was coming into White House as soon as she arrived.
Which is not a problem. Like, well, one of the nini, press secretary alisema, Sean Spicer, in his own words, said, I don't think he had the question. I sema tu kweli, ulisikia Donald Trump, ulisikia history.
But let me tell you something, Donald Trump is not the only man who went viral this week. It is also the Ghanaian footballer, Mohamed Anas, who plays for South Africa. And this week, he confessed that he is grateful to both his wife and girlfriend.
Imagine, you send a shout out to your girlfriend and also to your wife.
Now, of course, this is what he says in his own words, and I quote, "My family knows that I call my daughter my girlfriend. That is what I was talking about. I do not have a girlfriend."
Who does that? Let's look at the video. Who does that?
Something is a good achievement, but looking at the balance of play, I'm sure you could have won that game tonight.
Thank you very much. And I thank Almighty God who is above. I always wish to win one of these, and I got it. So thank you very much for this, for giving me this. And I appreciate my friends also, my wife and my girlfriend. Yeah, I mean my wife. Yeah, sorry to say. I'm so sorry, my wife. Lizzo, I love you so much. Aya, I love you so much from my heart. Ne? So must keep on supporting me. And thanks for to come to the game. Yeah, we need the 3 points because the position we are, it's unfortunate, it's not good, it's not bad. Bye.
I'd like to thank my wife. Oh sorry, I'd like to thank my girlfriend. Uh-huh. My girlfriend is my wife. Uh-huh. Oh, my daughter is my girlfriend.
But I'm sorry.
But I'm sorry.
And I love you.
Mohamed Anas was named man of the match. Imagine.
And let me tell you something. That video alone got over 250,000 views.
Actually, zimepanda.
Zimepanda by now.
Mbuko nikiangalia saizi nafika ka 300 na kitu.
Oh my goodness. There you go. And of course, that viral hit after the, you know, had a draw with Ajax Cape Town, which was 2-2. And the Ghanaian striker made a lot of conversation this week.
Yeah. And speaking of that, we have a lot of wind of change. Change is coming. In the famous words of Samuel Cook.
Ahead.
Sam Cook. Ooh. A change is gonna come.
Okay.
I was Hallelujah. Born by the river. Hallelujah.
All right, what Estelle is talking about is, listen, we want to know from you, what is your definition of change? How does change make you feel? That Kwa term me. Alone. How does that make you feel? Asili,
change,
how does it
make
you
feel? Change ni kudunga. Change ni look.
Really?
No, change
not siku change nguo. Oh, my goodness, this man.
Hapana, umeniliza change nini? Naweza kuwa change nguo. Change hairstyle.
No, not that, not that kind of change. Oh. Work with me.
Okay.
Okay, no. Work with me.
Sorry.
Okay, so this is, for example, Asili, change makes me feel nervous, but at the same time, it makes me know that I'm looking forward to something more positive.
Change makes me feel insecure because I don't trust change at times. But then, mi wana fikiria, change ni kitu poa sana.
So we want you to tweet us, what does change make, or rather, how does change make you feel? Tweet us at KTN News, use the hashtag #FeelTheChangeKE. And rather, this week coming, after the amazing weekend we're about to have, we'll be sharing some of your tweets on what's trending, all right? So take a look at this video. Wonderful.
Tense.
Fresh.
Anxious.
Nervous.
Ecstatic.
Poor.
Liberated.
Inanifurahisha.
Change makes me feel alive.
That's
change.
All. That's all.
Anxiety.
We change. Uh-huh. Okay, that's what we want to tell you. But before we take a quick break, I want you to listen to these statistics. When it comes to county criminal report that was done none other by the National Police Service in 2015, Nairobi criminal report stands at 4,383, Mombasa 3,194, mm-hmm. and Nakuru 4,384.
And imagine, tukitaka compare Mombasa na Nairobi, the level of crime has risen. In Mombasa, 83.33%, uh-huh. which is very high. And then Nairobi, 75.5%, which is also high.
75%?
75.5%.
Wow. Imagine. And that's the conversation we're going to have after this short break. We have two amazing reformed criminals, and you get to hear from them and feel inspired, and also psychologists here in studio to help us really understand. So, what are some of the questions that you have for our panel tonight? Tweet us at Brian_Sili.
At Zinzi_K.
And at KTN News. We'll be right back after this short break.